Have you, or anybody you know, ever facilitated or given a horrible, awful, miserable, boring training? Adam Spack, certified no boring trainer here. Here's the harsh reality. We all have. We've all given, we've all been part of, we've all delivered horrible, awful, miserable, boring training. Here's what you do when you know you've given a stinker to make sure it doesn't happen again the next time. We've all been there. We've all had those moments that as the class shuffles out of the room, we know in our heart of hearts, that didn't work. So here's what you do. The first step is to do an immediate after action report. Quickly bullet point what didn't work. Just in the heat of the moment, bullet point out this, that, the other thing. Don't go into some sort of analysis. Don't go into what if. Don't overthink it. Just capture that raw data. The second thing you want to do is lean heavily into your feedback structures. Make sure for the feedback of that particular session, you really lean into, you really prompt and guide your respondents to tell you what didn't work. Don't let them get away with the fluffy, oh, it was okay. Get them to tell you, this didn't work, that didn't work, this was horrible, this was awful, I was hot, I didn't learn anything, I fell asleep, whatever.
Oh.
The third thing you want to do is wait a couple days. Wait a couple days for the emotions to come down. Sometimes in the heat of the moment, we're not able to be coldly objective, we're not able to really look at the facts, and we might not make or draw the right conclusions. Let everything kind of calm and settle down a bit. Then go back to the after action report and that feedback you got. That is when you want to dive into what is the information telling you. You'll have your own reflections and that of the participants that you can then really lean into. You can combine that with the normal things. Was my objective clearly defined? Was the outcome that I was aiming at clearly laid out and communicated to the participants? Did I do a proper analysis? Did I prepare correctly and have all the right materials? Did I do proper contingency planning so if something went haywire, I responded in the moment? Did I ask questions and guide them to figure out the answers for themselves? Did I have games, activities, and experiential learning? Did I read the slides? All of that basic stuff you can then really lean into in combination with the data you gathered a little while ago. That's when you're going to really be able to sift through and figure out, okay, this is what I need to do to course correct for the next time. Another important step is to not beat yourself up. Don't get down in the dumps. Don't put energy into, oh, woe is me, and really overthinking, overanalyzing, and just going down the rabbit hole of, and getting all sort of emotional over it. Yes, it stings. Yes, it's embarrassing. Yes, it's no fun. And yes, you feel like you've let people down. Absolutely. That's how I feel when I have a clunker session. But you can't let that pull you away from course correcting for the next time. And that's the important thing. Learn from your mistakes and drive on. So stinker, clunker, awful, horrible, miserable, boring training sessions. We've all had them. We've all given them. I've given them. We all have those things that just don't work. Learn from the next time. And here's a process that you can follow to gather the right information, really diagnose what went wrong, so you can change it for the next time. How do you go about dealing with the aftermath of a session that just didn't work? What I missed? Let me know. Leave me some comments down below.